Today's topic is about the concept of balance. What do we mean by balance? Balancing your checkbooks, I think everybody understands what I mean. Walking on a tightrope is also an act of balance. There's a very pleasant and enjoyable example of maintaining balance, that is, riding a bicycle. In fact, maintaining balance in health is like riding a bicycle. Let me give you some illustrations about maintaining balance in health. Maintaining balance in health is not a mechanical process, nor is it a mathematical equation. It's a dynamic balance because things are moving and changing all the time. It's not a static one. Maintaining balance is a long-term process. It happens every day. It only stops when you're dead. When we think about the bicycle model, it would make balancing effort easier and more enjoyable. Every day our balance is disturbed. What are the disturbances? The disturbances are illness, trauma, stress, bad habits, addictions, etc. We should not be afraid of these disturbances because they are never fatal, except the final one. That means when you die, you lose balance the last time, only once, because your body always have the ability to recover. Since balance is a dynamic one, not a static one, like riding a bicycle, that means we can enhance and move the balance point to a higher plane. When we move to a balance point, that means we have a more robust body, able to recover faster. The same way, if we don't maintain our health well, we may slide downward to a lower balance point. In that case, we have poor health. So to enjoy life, we have always to strive to achieve a higher point or prevent our existing balance point from sliding downward. Now we come to how to achieve balance. Everybody, in fact, is in general balance because if you're not, you're dead already. And everybody knows that if we want to look at the mechanics of achieving balance, it's very complex. For practical purpose, we don't have to bother about the minute mechanical details. We just need to look at the results. And balance should be measured by feel, not by scientific method. It's very simple. When we're in balance, we feel healthy and happy. When we're out of balance, we don't feel good. And the recovery after the disturbance depends on the nature of the disturbance, your state of health, and what you do to help recovery. If you are at a higher balance point, recovery will be easier and faster. But if you are at a lower balance point, recovery will be more difficult and slower. Finally, we come to the Chinese approach to maintain balance in health. We let the body do its balancing. We don't bother about the minute details. The only thing we do is that we use herbs to speed up the recovery process. And there are two kinds of recovery depending on the disturbances. The first kind is temporary disturbances. The temporary disturbances are like flu and coughing, which you know that it will disappear very soon. So we use herbs to purge the disease poisons from the body so as to make the recovery faster. As for the long-term or recurrent disturbances, such as joint pains, allergy, skin rash, aging, and many others, we use herbs to strengthen the major organs, the qi, and the blood. In this way, we strengthen the body and let the body do the work. In Chinese medicine, there is no manual intervention to achieve a balance point. Everything depends on the body. Because of that, we have less bad side effects.
Cheek to a thrill that I